politics is very much in the news today because of Ed Miliband's decision to go and visit the comedian Russell Brand.
Alright, mate.
What's important is this bloke will be in Parliament, and I think this bloke will listen to us.
Politics is not a joke. Russell Brand's a joke. Ed Miliband, hang out with Russell Brand. He's a joke.
I think a joke is saying that you want this election to be about leadership and then refusing to debate me.
Here it is, 10 o'clock, and we are saying the Conservatives are the largest party.
I think for a moment, I got caught up in some mad, the thick of it, like, oh wow, Ed Miliband's in my house. My only regret in this is I thought that I could be involved. Like, you know, like people were telling me, like journalists and people that know loads about politics, look, if Labour don't get in, it's going to really be bad because independent living fund will get cut, public services are going to get cut more than ever, it's going to get worse for very poor people, the climate of the country is going to become sort of mean and nasty. And now, actually, the Conservatives have won. And then there was a sort of a moment where I felt like, ah, old media doesn't have the same sort of power that it used to. People don't listen to the front pages of The Sun and The Mail. These things seem kind of ridiculous. But evidently, that is not the case. Evidently, the old media, the establishment, is a powerful thing. David Cameron is the Prime Minister of this country with more seats than before after all of the things that have been happening for the last 5 years. The result is... let's keep that guy in charge. We're going to have no shortage of meanness over the next 5 years. There's going to be meanness to the disabled. There's going to be meanness to immigrants. There's going to be meanness to the poor. So all we've got left is to be compassionate to one another and get involved in causes we care about. People are telling us we could make an influence, and even though it's only a sort of a small thing, it would be better if the independent living fund's not cancelled, if education's not cut, if health's not cut. I mean, I was at the doctor with my mum today, and thank God she's all right. That really sort of put things in perspective, and I thought, thank God I'm in a position where I can take care of my mother as well, because it's going to be a lot harder for people that can't. The only thing that I can look to positively is that change does happen. Syriza happened in Greece, even though they're now fighting the giants of the EU to bring about anything meaningful. Podemos look like they're going to do something in Spain the next election, and I think there is a possibility for a new kind of politics. Not long ago, a slim majority like this, like the Tories are going to get, would have been looked at as a disaster. Now, for them, it's looked at as a huge victory. That's an indication that politics has changed in some way. What I've personally learned is, I don't understand that world, and I intuitively don't like it. My feeling is that change is going to come from us, come from ordinary people working together. Me as a human being, I'm now part of a society that is explicitly said, immigrants, poor people, NHS users, you are all in a lot of trouble. We gotta do
something. In a couple of hours, I will no longer be leading this party.
Doesn't really have to be a future in that.
You gotta move on.
Who cares? Who cares? Who does?
I just hope this doesn't ruin our friendship.
But that I've got fundamental disagreements with you.
Please, don't take it seriously.
That's what I am.
Hey, well, what's that about? What about a code of the ocean? That's not odd.
Am I tough enough? I'm tough enough? Hell yes, I'm tough enough.
You sound like you're from London.
But hang on a minute, hang on a minute. So when we have
it's
a
not
party,
true.
This was not true.
So you are in a position to...
like the Sopranos. It's over. Find a new show.
That's always not the way I see it, is it? I pray that you believe my song,
darling. Excuse me, missus. I've lost a shoe like this, but it's sort of the exact opposite, in fact. It's like this one's fellow. So why don't you do
something? Don't do anything. The less you do, the more you do.
Because we're leaving them to their own devices, the poorest are making all of the sacrifices, the cost of living crisis, house prices, the cost of a deposit. I don't give a shit. But yes, of course, we should address it. So we will blame the deficit on people claiming benefits. And as we debate what people get from the state, we don't care about how long people have to wait in A&E. We don't care about your GP. We have to get the money. It's important to me. And as the NHS is being sold off, it's businesses that get the profit in their pockets. Make sure the tops stay better off. Make sure the money stops at the top. Take every penny from the hands of the many and give everything to the few.
Where is the fairness? We couldn't care less.
One tax law
for the rich and another
for the rest.
and we will take interest in the very richest.
Let us make the poor
the richest.
Tax evasion is a man-made disaster.
These are the people I serve as Chancellor. I know
the answer is to build
the wallets of the rich and balance the bills on the backs of the poor.
The rich pay less tax. Let us make sure they don't pay anymore.
And as my chums move their money offshore, I am the one holding open the door. Let us be the party that makes you cry, but madness is voting for the other guy.
Good morning, everybody.
Our ideas are
partly fear
of people from different cultures coming here.
And when I hear our policies about ethnic minorities, we're the only party that actually believes in social mobility. Because our ability to push migrants
on a boat is my personal priority.
Yes.
The majority of our policies blame
people who come from other countries.
Employment legislation.
Blame immigration.
Excessive regulation.
Blame immigration. Bad education.
Blame immigration.
No qualification.
Blame immigration. Radicalization.
Blame immigration.
Unhappy situation.
Blame immigration.
The intimidation
in our nation.
When we
blame immigration is a total abomination.
At home and abroad, we can afford to press pause and put the needle on the record. Make sure the tops stay better off. Make sure the money stops at the top. Take every penny from the hands of the many and give everything to the few. We are not all in this together. We want to help the rich get richer forever. The poor will get a chance. Never. We don't give a damn about you.